hosting the Roadrunners of Bakersfield, who stand at 4-2. Hello again, everybody. I'm Jim, along with Matt Peterson. And this is a kind of a big game for UVU.
I think that it's been vital for the Wolverines to win tonight because they've come off a very tough home loss on Thursday against Seattle Redhawks. And they've got a very good Bakersfield coming in tonight. You got to win these home games in your conference, especially this time of the year. And I think probably more than anything, the Wolverines need to find a rhythm, get back into what they're used to, and hopefully they'll come away with a win tonight.
Wolverines have won two out of their last three. It was just that bizarre game 48 hours ago where all sorts of players fouled out, technicals, monitor reviews. UVU was not able to get it into their face. They have to do
that. Yeah, absolutely. I think one of the things we're going to look at in just a minute is, you know, shooting the basketball. The Wolverines really struggled, and they're going to face a tough test tonight from the Bakersfield team, who is very good defensively. So they have to be focused from the get-go on offense if they're going to win.
So this marks the halfway point of the WAC regular season. All the teams will have played each other once after tonight. So if UVU is going to win this thing, key players you're looking at, Matt.
You know, these are kind of the guys that we look at most games because they carry so much of the load for UVU. Connor Fry leading the team in scoring, 15 a game. He's going to have to be big. Marcel, the guy who gets the Wolverines going from the opening tip, he needs to play a little bit better tonight than what he did on Thursday. He played his normal game, but he's going to have to be extra special tonight, and these two guys will have to be special for UVU.
Meanwhile, for Bakersfield, it comes in here having lost two in a row, but they have won six in a row previously to that. They've got some pretty darn good players.
Yeah, Ali Ahmed, we're used to seeing him. He's a big guy inside. He has a very big body, and he is extremely skilled. And then you have Kevin Hayes, who also plays inside. He's averaging, you know, 12.5 points a game. So the Wolverines defensively are going to have to be up for the challenge on their interior inside to try and stop these two players.
And both those guys are seniors from Bakersfield, so they've got plenty of experience. They're not going to get rattled in this situation. So for UVU to be able to win this game tonight, keys to victory for UVU.
You know, going back to controlling the pace. On Thursday night, Seattle controlled the pace of the game. The Wolverines, in order to win, are going to have to play at their pace. They've got to do a good job of rebounding. We just mentioned two big guys inside for the Roadrunners. The Wolverines are going to have to rebound the basketball offensively and defensively, and then knocking down open shots. It was a bad shooting night on Thursday. 31% from the field, 31% from three for the Wolverines. So when they get that, when they get those open shots as a result of their offense, they've got to knock them down.
14th meeting between these two. Bakersfield leads the series 7-6. Bakersfield was the last team to beat UVU last year down in Las Vegas tournament. Knocked UVU out and ended their season like a little revenge. We're going to step aside, take a break when we get back. Back at the UCCU Center, Bakersfield will start Basil, Mays, Arrington, Ahmed, and Pride. Meanwhile, Utah Valley, Davis, Jackson, Fry, Young, and Bastion. The 14th straight game that Utah Valley has started. This five, two seniors and three juniors. Ali Ahmed will jump center for Bakersfield against Connor Fry. And this WAC battle is underway. Bakersfield controls the opening tip. See what they can do on their opening possession.
They're going to go early and often right here. And that is not a what the Wolverines needed, a quick early foul there from Andrew Bastion.
It just wouldn't be a UVU game without Bastion getting a foul in the first 30 seconds.
Yeah, I mean, it's true. It's very true. And you see what the Wolverines are going to do a few nights ago against Jack Crook. The ball goes inside. Double team. That time, another double team is coming over when the ball goes inside to Ahmed. That's going to be the Wolverines' game plan.
Poor Andrew Bastion's been called for a foul just for being on the court sometimes, it seems like. Arrington will take this first jumper and bury it.
Yeah, that was a nice pass out of the double team by Ahmed. Good ball movement for the Roadrunners.
So Bakersfield draws first blood in this one. And there's your first steal of the game, Basil. 4-0, very quickly, Bakersfield.
And Bakersfield putting pressure on certain players. You see Marcel being denied full court. You got Jaden being denied full court.
Ivory Young won't go, and a blocking foul gets called against Kevin Mays.
It's a good attack there from Ivory. He comes hard off of the screen from Andrew Bastian. Turned the corner really quick. He didn't waste any time. He didn't waste any space. Good sign to see him at the line early. Get his rhythm set early, too.
Ivory hasn't been at the free throw line that much this year. This is just his 19th free throw of the season. He's now 16 of 19.
He's got Mays coming out of the game, Jim.
Quickly.
Kevin Mays, the trainer's looking at him. He's looking like he's limping a little bit. Probably going to look at him, but that would be a big loss for Bakersfield.
One of your two key players in this game.
Yeah, absolutely. Matt Smith comes in for some early minutes.
Smith only averages 13 minutes a game. He's in here the first minute and a half, gone. 4-1 Bakersfield with the early lead. Five-second shot clock. Barely get it off in time. Rebound comes down to Connor Fry. Jaden Jackson finishes it off.
And that play right there, Jim, is exactly what the Wolverines want as you get the action picking up here. But you get a terrific defensive possession. You get a shot clock at the buzzer. A shot at the buzzer. And then based off of the rebound, the Wolverines are out and running. That's exactly what they want to do. They weren't able to do that a couple of nights ago.
Basil's floater won't go. Wolverines on the run again. Jackson, pull up two. Wolverines out front after five straight points. Jackson's got four of those. He had a tough time getting untracked 48 hours ago. Spin move. Put Smith wide open, but he missed the shot. Wolverines coming back the other way quickly.
Stepped out of bounds. A lot of life, a lot of energy right now from the Wolverines, and it stems from what they've done on defense. They gave up a quick 4 points, but they've really stiffened up here in the last few minutes, and it's led out to some transition opportunities. Got Bakersfield on their heels a little bit here.
No! Jackson misses. Marcel Davis finishes. Marcel Davis, the senior from American Fork, Utah, following up Jake Jackson's miss.
I believe he was the passer, right? I believe he was the one that inbounded the ball, so nice recognition by him crashing the glass.
Ali Ahmed, who has a pretty decent jump shot, shows you right there proof of that. Ivory Young for three. Bastian with the rebound for Utah Valley. Connor Fry this time. Wolverines coming right back with it. Jackson tried to dish off. Bakersfield was there to take it away, and now Bastian reaches in. He pulls it down. Jump ball called. Possession arrow, Utah Valley.
Kevin Mace checking back in here, but game turned a little bit sloppy there for both teams on the possession.
Wolverines start 4 of 6 from the floor. Bakersfield starts 3 of 6. And And another UVU turnover, their third. For the tie, Arrington.
Arrington just stepped into that one. A little bit of a mistake in transition for the Wolverines. This is one advantage that the Wolverines might have. You see Connor Fry bringing the basketball up. Bakersfield double-teamed Marcel, tried to trap him in the backcourt. Connor's skilled enough. He can bring that basketball up, push the action like he did, and gets the foul drawn.
Media timeout, just under 16 left here, first half. We're tied at 9. Welcome back to the UCCU Center. Wolverines and the Roadrunners tied at 9. 5 turnovers already between these two teams.
One of the differences that I've seen tonight, a couple nights ago playing against the Redhawks from Seattle, Seattle played that 3-2 zone the entire night. Bakersfield is not going to the zone so far. They're playing in a man-to-man offense, which I think is a better suited defense for the Wolverine offensive attack.
Ivory Young misses that one inside. Bakersfield coming back the other way. This is Brent Rapp, his first appearance in the game for Bakersfield. Now Durham will take the jumper for 3 and miss it. Ahmed clears the board. And UVU being called for the reach-in foul. Team second.
Pretty good move there from Ahmed. Got the post up. He spun to his right. He saw that Bastion and another UVU defender were coming over, and he did a nice job of being patient and turning back in. I think it was Marcel that got called for the reach.
Mays.
We talked about one of the keys to the open was going to be the rebounding for the Wolverines. Giving up an offensive glass here. Nice move from Ivory Young. This is an aggressiveness we're not accustomed to seeing it from him in the last few games. A great sign to see him coming off that ball screen when he gets it on the wing, and he's driving aggressively.
Ahmed dished over to Mays. Stripped out of bounds. It'll be Bakersfield basketball. 4 out of 5 UVU starters have scored. 3 out of 5 for Bakersfield. Another foul against UVU.
You know, this was an inbounds play run for Ali Ahmed. They set a screen for him, giving him a mid-range jump shot, and Andrew's going to be coming out of the game because he went for the challenge. It's just his momentum carried him into Ahmed. And this is going to put a lot of stress and pressure for the Wolverine bench because you've got Darius Hamilton now coming in. Very unlikely that we'll see Andrew Bastian for the remaining of the first half as he has those two fouls. This is what I mean by this pressure. See if Marcel just gets that ball immediately back to Connor. That time he didn't. He held on to it, but.
A foul right here in front of us. Going to go against Rapp.
Bakersfield's very confident in their ability to put pressure on the guards for the Wolverines. They, the back pressure, you know, backcourt pressure that we're talking about. But watch them extend their on-ball pressure well beyond the three-point line. We've got right here Basil way out on Marcel, and Rapp's been putting pressure as well coming off of the screens.
Hayden Skank into the game, as is Darius Hamilton for Utah Valley. You saw Connor Fry take a seat for a breather. Davis takes it in. Contact, no foul called, but the putback is good from Hamilton.
Nice positioning there from Darius with the ball knocked away on the wing by Ivory, but Marcel did a really nice job. The defense is so used to Marcel taking that, or the Wolverine offensive players taking it off of the screen using his left hand. That time Marcel took it away from the screen, took it away from the screen to his strong hand. Got a terrific look at the rim.
Ali Ahmed blocked up top by Hamilton. Not that time.
Yeah, great effort initially from Darius. It's just kind of a scramble play from there. Bakersfield with numbers underneath.
UVU being called for what, an illegal screen?
Illegal
Is that what
screen.
It was?
You know, this happens multiple times a game for the Wolverines.
Why?
Well, I think the bigs set so many screens. Andrew Bastian comes up at that exact same spot. Darius Hamilton sets the screen. And part of it's the guy who's coming off of the screen, because he's not waiting for the screen to be set to come off of it. But part of it is the bigs are not set either. And so with the Wolverines setting so many screens on the perimeter, we often see those moving screens.
Bakersfield very fortunate not to turn it over. A foul on the battle for the rebound underneath.
Wow, and that's two fouls now on Darius.
Bastion's already on the bench for UVU with two fouls. Now Darius Hamilton picks up his second. Wolverines were in all sorts of foul trouble Thursday night against Seattle.
Now this is going to be, I think, a little problematic for the Wolverines. Deion Goodman's going to be coming in, but you know, I think at this point you're probably going to see Darius back in at some point, or Andrew back in, because Bakersfield has size that the Wolverines have to contend with, and the two big guys now have the two fouls for the Wolverines, and that time it was just kind of another broken play. Bakersfield coming up with, you know, they've got four offensive rebounds so far, and it's led to a couple points.
You saw Fry, Hamilton, and Bastian all on the bench already for UVU. 4-point lead for Bakersfield. Their biggest here in this first half.
Yeah, look at this extended pressure. I mean, it is way out beyond the three-point line.
Jaden for three. Bottom.
That's how you can combat the pressures, if you get a big on small screen, or you know, find your opportunities to drive to the rim. Nice shot from Jaden.
57 straight games at UVU's now hit a three-pointer. Speaking of threes, Durham from the corner. Davis comes down quickly, trying to stay with him was Dedrick Basil. Basil being called for the foul, his first, team's fourth. Bakersfield's been whistled for four, Utah Valley for five.
And for the Wolverines, you know, keep that aggression. I think they're doing a nice job of playing at their pace so far. Keep that aggression. You know, Bakersfield is going to be putting pressure. You get a long three here from Marcel, knocks it down, but they got to keep that aggression to keep Bakersfield honest with their perimeter defense.
Wolverines now 2 of 3 from long range. Same stat for Bakersfield. 2 out of 3. Just a one-point Bakersfield lead at this junction. Goodman reaches in for the ball and commits a quick foul. Not what you want from your big man replacement. Media timeout. We'll take it with them. Bakersfield, Utah Valley. Pretty even battle thus far. Just under 12 to play first half.
The Western Athletic Conference.
Well, despite the size differential, right now UVU out-rebounding Bakersfield by one. But it's Bakersfield with a one-point lead on the scoreboard.
Yeah, and Wolverines with 8 points in the paint compared to six for Bakersfield. A lot of those points for UVU have been off their dribble penetration and points from their guards. And, you know, the Wolverines are 1 point behind here, but a great sign in the fact that they're shooting the ball much better tonight than they did a few nights ago.
Durham. Back to a four-point lead. Matches Bakersfield's largest in the half.
Durham is by far the highest shooter of threes for Bakersfield. He has 165 on the year coming into the game, so he's going to be one of the players that the Wolverines has to get out on.
Yeah, in fact, that ranks 13th in the nation.
Yeah, that's incredible. And you can see he's a good shooter. You know, he's got a lot of range, and that's kind of what his game is around the three-point line. So Connor, in this case, guarding him, has got to make sure that he's on him at all times. Here comes another double screen for him.
7 second shot clock. Rapp drives in, gets it to go down off the glass.
Good job of not fouling there from Ivory. That's a tough finish from Rapp.
Ivory Young for three, the other way, bottom.
Yeah, that's a beautiful offense there because there's nobody in the middle of the paint for Bakersfield because they're all out guarding the perimeter players for the Wolverines. That time, Connor pushed the action. The defender, Rab had to come back in to help on the drive, and a nice timed kick out for Connor for Ivory and the three.
Wide open, Basil for three. Wolverines can tie with a three.
You see how Dayon is up at the top here, Jim? He's looking to set a lot of screens. He'll find his way down to the paint, but he's going to be coming up and spending a lot of his time setting screens up at the three-point line.
.10:09 to play first half. Jade Jackson back in. Ivory Young will take a seat for UVU. Marcel Davis for three. Wolverines control. Connor Fry for three. Wolverines now 3 of 6 from long range.
And they're going to continue to shoot, and they've got some good looks. You know, that's the difference between the Wolverines are at their best and when they're just okay is, you know, if they can make that long three-point shot.
Live and die by the three. They've had some amazing performances from long range so far this season.
It's going to be a three-second call on Ali Ahmed.
You don't see that very often.
You don't, and it was a good call because he was posted up. He was open a couple times, surprised they didn't dump it into him, and he never got out of the paint.
Just Bakersfield's third turnover. Goodman, fake left, fake right, finally went left. And traveled.
I'd love to see Dan shoot that. You know, we don't see him with a mid-range game much. He's more of kind of what he tried to do there with the drive. I think if he's open there, he's got to take that jump shot. Ali Ahmed's going to get another stepped out at the last second. He's busy posting up inside.
Wolverines come away with a miss. That's Hayden Skank pull down that rebound. Skank one of four walk-ons on this team for UVU.
Terrific ball movement here. Wolverines have Bakersfield absolutely scrambling. But they scrambled and they didn't get a shot taken from the Wolverines. A couple good looks I thought that Marcel had, that Connor had. Hayden even had one in the corner there, should have let it fly.
Seconds on the shot clock for UVU. Connor Fry will take the three. UVU now 3 of 7. Durham. Oh
wow.
My goodness. Damian Durham, redshirt freshman from Oakland, Texas.
Well, Jaden got out there. He was a little late, but he gave a good contest, as you see. Hayden Skank getting called for, number 11, Jalen Arrington getting called for the foul. Bakersfield wanted a hooking offensive call there on Jaden. But back to Durham, Jaden got out there and contested. It was just a deep three, and he seems to be feeling it tonight.
Connor Fry just waits, Hayden Skank just waits for everybody to go flying by above him. Goes up, gets the and one.
Yeah, Bakersfield players underneath called for a switch, but it was just way too late. The communication was not in time, and Hayden wide open underneath the basket. Terrific job of drawing the contact and finishing the play.
Well, the contact must happen well before that
shot. It was. That was when he was almost coming down.
First 2 points of the night for Hayden's game. Hayden pulls the Wolverines to within three. 8 minutes left in this first half. Doing everything they can to deny Ali Ahmed.
What a pass.
Ahmed is so good, not just in scoring, but in dishing off the ball, like you saw right there.
It's such a quick read. I mean, he knows that the double team is coming. Ball goes into him, immediately gets dished off to Pride, and he gets fouled.
Stink. The last 3 points, Wolverines pick up the foul. Back in a minute here on UVU TV.
Who's like this?
Utah Valley. Still down by three, despite shooting 56%. Much improved from what they did Thursday night, when they shot only 31% for the entire game. But still, Bakersfield at 53% tonight with the three-point lead.
Yeah, statistically really even. Both teams with 10 made field goals. Nine rebounds for the Wolverines, eight for Bakersfield. Pretty close across the board here for both teams, hence the close game.
Justin Bryant hits the first of two. And the junior from Huntsville, Alabama, gives Bakersfield a five-point lead. Connor Fry takes it in, and a blocking foul against Bakersfield.
Yeah, there's again what Connor can do, because he stretches the floor. You know he's going to take he can take and will shoot the three. You get a closeout late, and you're going to see Connor drive hard here after the fake pass, and Ahmed comes over to take the charge, but it's not straight on. Nice job of Connor avoiding Ali Ahmed when he sees him there. Draws the contact.
Ahmed's first, team's eighth. Two-shot foul, Connor Fry.
And I really like the aggressiveness of UVU, because I've mentioned several times the fact that Bakersfield is in a man-to-man. They're going to put a lot of pressure on. So the way that you alleviate that is by driving the basketball. And I think you can also alleviate that moving the basketball as well. And the Wolverines have done a really nice job with both of those things.
Wolverines 4 out of 5 from the free throw line. They're 40th in the nation, by the way, in free throw shooting, according to the latest NCAA stats. And
wow.
Look at that long three from Durham. You got to be kidding me.
Well, and the Wolverines played a little bit different defense there. Hayden Skank was kind of at the top as Connor pushes the action here. Nice shot. I'll be surprised if Bakersfield continues that pressure, because it's absolutely killing them when Connor just brings that ball up. And if Ahmed is guarding him, and going to get a foul here on Kevin Mays, but Connor is just being able to bring the ball up. Bakersfield pressure full court is doing nothing, because Connor can pull the ball up and Ahmed has to guard him, and Ahmed's not going to come out and try and guard him at the three-point line. Connor realizes that has so much space when he comes across half court. He just simply pulled up for the jumper there.
Hayden Skank will be at the free throw line. Hayden Skank has been a very bright spot for the Wolverines this season. He just annoys the heck out of people. Opponents, I mean. Let's clarify
off the
that.
Off the court, Jim? Is that what you're talking about?
No. He's the greatest kid in the world off the court. I wouldn't want to play against him.
Your point is well taken, though, because he does. He plays hard. And you see what Hayden's doing right here, Jim? So he's not really guarding anybody. He's staying right there near the top. I can't tell what type of zone this is yet.
That's jumper good. Outside.
Shot there from Rapp.
6-point lead for Bakersfield matches their earlier 6-point lead. UVU's only lead was 3 points. Just 2 minutes and 45 seconds into this game. Five-second shot clock. Skank.
That was the best defensive possession so far for Bakersfield, and Durham's going to, oh, thought he was going to take another shot there, but really good defense from Bakersfield. Made the Wolverines work for everything they got there.
Durham's already hit 4 out of 5 three-pointers, got 12 points tonight, only player on either team in double figures.
And that time, Hayden get a little bit too aggressive. Reaching in, going to put Pride at the free throw line.
Skank's first foul, team's eighth against UVU.
You know, having been in a position that some of the Wolverine defenders are in right now on Durham, and he's going to be coming out of the game, you think, thank goodness, because it's really hard to guard somebody when they're on fire like that and they're not afraid to shoot from either side. and anywhere on the court, and Bakersfield has set a lot of double screens and motion and out in transition for him to get those open looks.
Justin Pride, 63% free throw shooter. It remains 35-29. 5.5 minutes left here, first half. Ivory Young for three, bottom. UVU has hit 4 out of 9. Bakersfield's hit 5 out of 7.
I think the Wolverines with this lineup for Bakersfield, look how much room they're giving Pride right there. And then when the ball gets over, if it goes to Rapside, watch how much room they'll give him at the three-point line. They're interested in letting those two guys shoot from three whenever they want.
Officials disagreed with the call. We'll see which one. To me, it looked like it was off UVU.
Yeah, they're gonna switch that up.
Durham back in. Pride takes a seat.
Yeah, I'll see a replay here, but it's too late. Yeah, the top official came in. Talked to Casey McClellan there. You see how they're just sucking in as far as Wolverine, certain players. They're giving a lot of these players shots. And just as they do, Rapp knocks it down.
Well, they might play Rapp a little closer now, huh?
Yeah, I mean, he's only shot 23 threes on the season, that being 24, and he's made 30% of them. So they're giving him that shot. Ali Ahmed's going to pick up foul number two right here. See Ahmed having to fight back down the lane, and nice job of Dayon. Quick, aggressive move.
So Dayon Goodman will be at the free throw line for Utah Valley. Goodman, one of just two sophomores on this team for UVU.
You know, looking at the stats, as I just mentioned, Brent Rapp has shot 23 threes on the season. Diedrich Basil has shot 88, but Justin Pride has not attempted a three this year. So they're going to lay off of him. I guess the only three, well, you've got Durham back in the game. Got to keep an eye on where he is. They'll give some of these shots.
Arrington.
Arrington's only attempted 42 as well, so he's not a three-point shooter.
Jaden Jackson certainly is. Misses that one. Connor Fry gives UVU a fresh 30-second shot clock to work with. Under 4 minutes left here in this first half.
Yeah, nice pass from Marcel. They're putting Ahmed in pick and rolls, probably thinking that he's got the two fouls. And Dayon has a speed advantage. When he sets that screen, Ahmed has to come out and hedge and help at the three-point line. Dayon rolls right to the basket, wide open there, because Ahmed has no time to recover and get back down the lane.
And Marcel Davis showing why he's fourth best in the WAC in assists. Comes in here averaging almost 5 a game. 5 second shot clock.
See, they'll do the same play here, Jim. They're getting Ahmed involved in a pick on the ball. You're going to get Dayon setting another screen here. Ahmed that time. Nice play there from Marcel, but.
And the breakaway from Basil. He blew that one. Are you kidding me? And Jade Jackson comes down and fouls Arrington. You don't get a much easier basket than Arrington just had. Or a chance at a basket, rather.
That good hustle by Arrington, following it up. Never assume anything. Doesn't use the backboard. Makes that shot more difficult than it should be. And Jaden gets called for the foul.
It was Basil who missed the layup. My fault. 38-34, Roadrunners. the UCCU Center. Utah Valley 3-3 in the WAC. Bakersfield just one game ahead of them in the standings at 4-2. So we talked in the pregame about the importance of this game really for UVU. You'd really like to finish the first half of the WAC play with a winning record, with a 4-3. That's a big difference from 3-4.
Yeah, and especially where they just went on the road and won those two games, and then they come back and they've got a great chance to build on that. Unfortunately, they didn't do so Thursday night, but playing well tonight.
Five-point lead for Bakersfield. Both teams have hit 13 shots from the floor, 13 apiece. Bakersfield's hit two more three-pointers than has UVU, and three more free throws than has UVU. Ivory Young for three. Bakersfield's lead is down to two.
Yeah, Rapp has to get sucked in as you get a drive there from Basil.
Jaden Jackson against Rapp. Bakersfield offensively, only one of their last six shots. Under two to play.
And they've really slowed down too, because Wolverines, once again, are giving a lot of these guys shots, and you get their own coming. Oh my goodness, that's a two-pointer. That's an incredibly difficult shot, because you're, as a right-hand shooter, you're coming to your left hand, fading away. Oh my goodness.
He's got 14 points.
Ooh, that should be basket interference.
They have Goodman back up, cannot get it down.
I thought the Bakersfield, Justin Hollins came over and knocked the ball or hit the rim. Yeah.
Well, he hit the net.
Got your hand in the net.
Is it basket interference to hit the net, though?
I'm not sure. I'm going to have to look at the rule on that, because
for your hand to go up through the net,
through
yes.
The net, yeah.
But to simply
my
hit the
concern
net.
Was, yeah, if he hit the net, and, you know,
right.
Moved the basket, then that. Either way, the Wolverines come away with the rebound. Dayon putting in some good minutes, some really important minutes tonight.
And a quick little timeout here taken by Bakersfield. Just a two-point lead for the Roadrunners. UVU hits the road again after this game, for the next three games. Two games next week, Thursday in Edinburgh against Rio Grande, and then a week from today on the road against New Mexico State. And then guess what? They have the whole week off until 2 weeks from today when they on the road again, and they'll play Bakersfield. So 2 weeks from today, these two teams meet again.
Yeah.
Pretty quick turnaround.
Yeah, it is. Yeah, and you look ahead tonight, again, going back to what you mentioned about it being an important game, because, you know, the Wolverines, you know, going down to Edinburgh, it's not an easy place to play, not an easy place to get a win. And then they got a really tough game at New Mexico State, and then they go to Bakersfield, as you mentioned. So, you know, when you factor in what the Wolverines have ahead, they've got to start playing their best ball. Here comes a couple more screens for Durham, and you're going to get an illegal screen there on Justin Hollins. A little too aggressive. I think the Wolverines knew what was coming, because Ivory Young basically stood at the top of the key. His man was not setting the screen. He was just giving extra help defense there, knowing that there was a double screen coming for Durham to get him free at the top.
Under a minute. Marcel Davis, shot blocked. Bakersfield couldn't quite get a handle on it to get the fast break. Wolverine basketball with 53.1. Wolverines could take the lead with a three. It'd be the first time since, at the 16:37 mark was the last time they led.
Yeah, they're talking here in front of us about whether or not there was a reset of the shot clock. One of the officials saying he, you know, got the ball, took a dribble, so there was possession, and therefore the reset.
Ivory Young has to kick it outside to Jackson. Goodman inside, he'll travel.
Again, he's just got to shoot that ball. I think he's trying to do too much with it, trying to get a little bit closer to the rim. Previously, we saw him at the elbow with the jump shot. You know, hard to fault him there because it's a natural thought. Hey, I got a lot of space. I'll try and go to the basket. But he's right there. He just needs to shoot that ball.
So 31 and a half seconds left here in this first half. Both teams have missed four of their last five shots apiece.
Let's see what Bakersfield does here. They're going to use time, use clock for the last shot. Let's see if they get Durham, who's in the corner, some type of movement coming to the top of the basket, coming off of a double screen. He's had the hot hand. They might just get it to him and set him in a pick and roll.
Shot will not go.
Oh, that basket's going to count. That basket is going to count.
The shot clock horn went off.
Yeah, it went off, and it shouldn't have because it hit the rim. I believe the ball hit the rim. We'll have to see a replay of that because I think they might review it. But the shot clock horn did go off, but the ball hit the rim.
So the horn should not have gone off.
The horn should not have gone off because here, yep, ball hits the rim. The Wolverine players think that's it. Ooh, that's going to be close. I think they'll definitely look at it, but Ahmed standing right there kept playing. I think the Wolverines and some of the Bakersfield players just kind of froze.
Yeah, the Wolverine players certainly froze when the shot clock horn went off. Coach Pope still waiting for the official explanation.
See, watch the replay here. So the ball goes off the rim, no doubt. We're going to have to watch the opposite basket shot clock here. So Ahmed comes down with it.
Oh, boy, that's close.
They called it good, so it's going to be really hard to look at that and reverse it.
Well, technically the scoreboard showing 43-39.
Because they counted. That is counting the basket, correct?
Yeah, the officials are over there looking at the monitor now. So
that is really close.
If they count it, it'll be 43-39. If they don't count it, it's 41-39. UVU will go to the locker room trailing either by four or by two.
Well, there was when Bakersfield inbounded the basketball, there was a 1.4 second differential. So
we might be able to see
this
it
will
here.
Be a good view because we'll see the light on the basket.
Up.
Yeah.
When the red lights come on, oh, it's good.
I think it is good too.
I think it was out of his hands before the light came on. We're gonna unofficially call that good. 43-39. The officials, I don't know what's taking them so long. I could have done this.
Yes, you could have.
Quite some time ago.
Well, they're looking at a much worse view than we are. Right now, I can see what they're replaying, and it's a much worse view than what we just had. We just had a terrific. Now they're zooming in down there.
Well, regardless, the Wolverines will be down at halftime. Where they are 1-9 this season, trailing at half.
And the Wolverine coaches are still out here. Maybe they're just waiting to see. Yeah, they're going to count the basket.
Okay, basket is good. 43-39, we're at halftime. We'll be back with our halftime show coming up next right here on UVU. Back at the UCCU Center, Wolverines of Utah Valley down by four at halftime to the Bakersfield Roadrunners, 43-39 the score. Both teams shooting exactly 50% in that first half. It was an entertaining first half and a pretty evenly played first half, Matt.
Yeah, you and I mentioned, well, you mentioned it to me, and I look at the stat sheet, absolutely. You know, it's pretty even across the board. You know, field goals right there. Both teams shooting close free throws, rebounds. The one difference is that Bakersfield has 12 assists. The Wolverines only with seven, but, I mean, geez, everything else is really close. Bakersfield does have 9 points currently off of the turnovers, the six turnovers for the Wolverines, and where Bakersfield is really dominating is on the bench points. They have they had 21 bench points in that first half. 14 of them have come from Damian Duran. So he's been fantastic off of the bench and provided them a spark where their starters haven't carried him so far.
Duran, 4 out of 5 from long range. We've got some highlights queued up from the truck, so let's roll those. I'll let you walk us through those, my friend, if you can.
Yeah, I think we're going to see a lot of good things from both teams. Ivory set the tone early. A theme we're going to see is, you know, for the Wolverines, there hasn't been many mid-range jump shots. It's either long-range shots on threes from dribble drives and kickouts, and or either penetrations all the way to the basket. That's what UVU's offense has been. And we'll probably see a lot of highlights from Bakersfield just of Damian Duran. You know, he has been fantastic. He's 4 of 5 from the three-point line. He had that other long two-point jump shot. So, you know, I think the Wolverines have done a really nice job of holding Ali Ahmed. He was going to be the main concern for me, and with the foul trouble that the Wolverines had early with Andrew Bashan going out, Darius Hamilton going out, Deion Goodman came in, filled those two players' shoes, and the Wolverines have done some really nice things on defense. It's just Damian Durham's hurt him with those long threes.
14 points for Duran. He's the only player for Bakersfield in double figures. Arrington and Ahmed with 8 each, Rapp with 7. Meanwhile, for Utah Valley, one player in double figures, that's Ivory Young. You saw him hit a couple of three-pointers there in the highlight package. 12 points for Ivory, 7 for Jade Jackson, 6 for Connor Fry, 5 for Marcel Davis. Andrew Bastian scoreless in that first half. Deion Goodman off the bench with 4. 21-9, though, bench points in the first half in favor of Bakersfield. As you pointed out, just brutal.
Yeah, I mean, look at the stats. I mean, they're right there in virtually every category except for the assists. And I mean, it's uncanny how close it is, and we've got a really close game as a result of it. And, you know, we're setting ourselves up for a pretty exciting second half here. Both teams are going to make some adjustments, I'm sure. Look forward to the second half, and it's going to come down to the wire, as it usually does.
We're at the UCCU Center on the campus of Utah Valley University here in Orem, Utah. UVU, by the way, celebrating their 75th anniversary this year, beginning in 2016. It's been in several iterations. They haven't been UVU. They haven't been a university for 75 years, but they've been around for a long time and done some pretty amazing things. A lot of folks around here calling this the miracle in the valley. Take a look.
Transpired over the ensuing 75 years is, by many accounts, nothing short of miraculous. But how far we've come in such a relatively short period of time. Here you won't find stories of others, including the Gothic architecture that came from hundreds of years. What you will find, and have always been able to find, is a campus full of workhorses and doers. That's what our institution is predicated on. The foundation of what is today known as Utah Valley University was laid by many, too many for many times, but none more so than by Wilson W. Sorensen. Originally held as purchasing agent and treasurer, he went on to become the institution's second president, a post he held for 37 years. Wilson devoted his life to this point, literally lowering his standards to pay the goats, and was just running up to himself. That attitude, shared by so many of them over the years, established a persistent, contest with the legacy of grit, determination, and ingenuity that have been hallmarks of the institution ever since. He also had a vision. We eventually outgrew the activities. Many other steps in Provo, before Wilson purchased 185 acres of farmland, facing to a gravel pit across town and farm, not facing as a gambling concern. This would prove a defining moment for the institution. Through the decades, whether in support of the war effort or the information aid, UU has always responded in kind with academic programs to match the region's ever-evolving workforce and economic development needs. One of the few constants of the news has been change. We're nothing if not nimble. Able to plant and adapt whenever needed. You'd be hard pressed to find another institution that has evolved from a hardy vocational school to a robust university in 75 years. We've grown in physical size and academic stature. But in some respects, the more things have changed, the more they stay the same. Foremost among them is a hands-on, experiential, and huge learning approach to education. You might say it's in our DNA, whether among us like student workers, computer programmers, or medical health professionals. No matter the discipline or level of study, our students have always had opportunities to learn about their domain and to enter the workforce with both diploma and resume. Resistance in need is a spirit of inclusivity that pervades our campus. Whether you can see or you can hear, admission is, if I deserve, open. We have always had a place. And we need support. Anyone willing to put forth the effort. Today, UVU students can choose our master degrees and 60-plus bachelor degrees. But we also continue to offer roughly the same number of associate degrees and dozens of certificate programs. It's an educational mission that is truly humanity. One focused on providing the group, the advanced training of first-generation university, and retaining access to the training and technical training of an open admissions institution where students' success is at the heart of everything they do, from supplying the aircraft to the money, from analog switches and lights to leading-edge digital CD printing, from oversized monochrome computers to laptops, tablets, and smart devices of the current generation. Student success and community responsiveness drive it all. One of the differences today is the scale upon which we're fulfilling this unique mission. Unparalleled in the nation, according to several industry experts, with enrollment recently exceeding the 33,000 mark, UVU is now the largest university in the state, and among the largest in the Western U.S. Another set of reputation extends far beyond county borders. The state, region, nation, and even Europe have taken note of Utah Valley University as a growing force in the higher education landscape. Today, the acreage of farmland and gravel are now nearly fully developed and filled nearly to capacity. Prompting President Matthew Holland, in his own self-described Wilson Stein's Amendment, to secure an additional 225 acres to help absorb future growth. The land, ironically and appropriately enough, sits on the side of the old Geneva School, where so many of our graduate students and graduates grew and worked professionally. In 2016, we honor and celebrate their legacy and the legacy of every student, professor, staff member, administrator, alumni, supporter, and friend ever associated with this university. It's a legacy that is now 75 years strong, and it grows stronger with each passing semester. Give us another 75 years and watch what we accomplish. As President Holland has said, this university is hardwired to overcome seemingly insurmountable obstacles for pride and ingenuity, it is in my genius. reason being that she's done inception in 1941. I think that we have to do some of the best to take and we wouldn't have it in another way.
Wolverines and the Roadrunners. Pretty tight battle in the first half, if that's any indication of what we'll see in the second half. Expect a whole bunch of three-pointers and a couple of lead changes, maybe. First half saw two lead changes and three ties.
Hopefully Ivory can keep up his production. 12 big points in the first half. He'll need that from him as Marcel hasn't played his best and Connor's been held in check.
Same starting five on the floor for both of these teams that started the first half. Mays rolls that one off. Ivory takes it all the way to the hole, lays it up and in. There you go. Answers your question, my friend.
Yeah, the Wolverines, Jaden Jackson several times, Ivory that time. When that shot goes up, they're leaking out. They're getting out to the half court line and getting that ball passed ahead.
Mays jumper.
You know, Mays was really quiet in the first half, Jim. Only 2 points, and he averages on the year 12 and a half. So as he gets called for the foul right here, but you know, he got the ball and the drive on the first possession and the jumper on the second. So he's.
Yeah, well, the bad news is Kevin Mays just picked up foul number 3.
Yeah, and see, here again, I don't quite understand the philosophy as Jaden Jackson gets a quick basket inside on the inbounds play. Don't quite understand why they're trying to deny Marcel the ball because Connor is just tearing him up with his transition offense when he brings the ball up.
He missed that basket from Jaden, but it cuts the lead to 2. Off the glass, Justin Pride.
Yeah, that's one thing you never want to give up if you're going to lay off him and not, you know, give him any space. Get a turnover here.
Basil on the breakaway. Jackson did not try to contest that one from behind.
That time he used the glass, too. Learned from that miss in the first half where he didn't use the glass.
6-point lead for Bakersfield. It's been their biggest lead now 3 different occasions in this game. Yeah. Avery Young for an NBA three. Bakersfield the other way. Justin Pride all the way. Rebound back up and in from Kevin Mays.
Yeah, Wolverines didn't get back in transition. Kevin just ran right down the lane.
Six straight points from Bakersfield. Now they have their biggest lead. Something didn't look right inside. Foul's going to get called against Bakersfield.
You know, and tonight Ivory's been creating the offense because you see him get the ball up top. Nice pass fake there. Nice hesitation dribble, draws Mays over. Andrew Bastian wide open for the layup. Ivory can't say enough about his play tonight. He's knocked down some threes, but creating offense off of his dribble penetration has made him a dual threat tonight.
Fouls on Justin Pride, his second. Bakersfield's second of this half. Bastian, junior from Tustin, California, buries the second one of two. Wolverines down by seven. Bakersfield's on a little streak here. They've hit four out of their last five shots, making it four out of six. Jackson with the hanging jumper for two. He's got 11 points. Three minutes deep here into the second half.
Here comes Durham off a double screen.
Three-pointer won't go for Durham. Wolverines control. Marcel Davis kicks outside to Fry. He'll put up the little fall-away one-hander. Pride can't get that one down. Wolverines back the other way. Back and forth they go. Connor Fry looking for some help. Bastian working against Ali Ahmed.
Good hustle there from Connor. That was good defense from Ahmed. I like how Andrew pushed and forced the action a little bit. He's got to be a threat inside. Going to get some substitutions from both teams here. Excuse me, just from Bakersfield. But you know, those are the little plays that you have to give yourself another opportunity. Connor coming in, forcing Durham to give extra effort on the defensive glass.
Connor Fry puts his head down, drives in. Ahmed blocks that one. Had something to say to Connor Fry once they both hit the ground.
Yeah, they're going to get Matt Smith with the foul here. Nice, nice ball fake there. Not sure where the foul was there from Smith. There was a lot of contact from Ahmed, but either way, Connor at the line.
Connor Fry with 7 points, three of them from the stripe. Wolverines have already missed six free throws. Very uncharacteristic for one of the best free throw shooting teams in the nation. 4 minutes and change gone here in the second half. Bakersfield with a 4-point lead. They led at halftime by four. Bastian went up and stopped Ali Ahmed. But he gets called for the foul. For Bastian, it's going to be foul number three.
Yeah, this is such a tough call because Andrew does a terrific job of challenging, but just the fact with his left arm, he didn't stay vertical. He brought it down and at angle, it's an automatic foul call for the official.
Wolverines down by four. 4-point Bakersfield lead. Just under 16 minutes left here at the UCCU Center. Third foul against Bastion. Mays already on the bench for Bakersfield with three. Nobody else for either team with more than two. Leading scorer still Durham for Bakersfield with 14. Ivory Young also with 14 for Utah Valley. Ali Ahmed at the free throw line for the Roadrunners. And the senior from Alexandria, Egypt, buries the first one. 6'9", 250. I think he's bulked up a little bit from when we saw him last year.
He looks like he has. He definitely has. He's been really active in posting up. He's going to get subbed out of the game right here, but the Wolverines, I think, for the most part, have done a really nice job of their post defense on him. You know, he hasn't had a lot of easy baskets. He's made some jumpers, made some free throws, but, you know, for the most part, when he gets the ball, he's being double teamed and forced to pass the ball out of the double team.
Anthony Bastion slams that one down. His first basket of the night.
That's the drive and kick effect that the Wolverines do on offense. No one left in the middle because everybody had to suck over and help try and stop Marcel Andrew right down the lane. Thunderous finish.
You got to figure Andrew was like, thank goodness Leon Med is on the bench right now. And guess what? Back the other way, Matt Smith, 6'6", redshirt junior from Jackson, Tennessee, does the same thing.
Look at the defense here for Bakersfield. It's a 2-3 zone, kind of extending it up almost to be a 3-2 zone. They're not playing man anymore.
Turnover, Wolverines. Their eighth of the game. 14 and a half minutes to play.
Wow.
Good gracious, Damian Durham. Tell me the kid's a freshman. He's a redshirt freshman, but my goodness gracious, 17 points.
And Marcel got picked on the screen. Andrew a little later in the rotation. That's going to be a charge.
They'll wave off the basket. New rule this year in the NCAA, you cannot score if you charge.
Now that's the first time tonight of all the dribble drives and of all the penetration that the Wolverines have done, that's the first time tonight that we've seen a charge and probably the best rotation from Bakersfield all night because Matt Smith coming over, taking the charge right in the chest. You know, who do you think they're going to go to here, Jim? Bakersfield.
Gee, I would put the ball in the hands of number 23.
They're going to do some type of screen. They're going to do some handoff. Be crazy not to get him involved somehow here.
Under 10 on the shot clock. Harrington working against Skink.
That's off that's off Marcel. They're saying that's off Harrington's leg. Great defense there on Durham. No chance of getting a shot off. Great defensive possession for UVU because you force, you know, a really difficult shot here. Terrific challenge there from Hayden Skank. Here comes that zone again.
UVU basketball, 13 and a half to play.
Now this is the zone that gave UVU trouble on Thursday night. 3-2 zone, they can extend it far out beyond the three-point line.
You think teams watch that tape? Ivory Young, my goodness gracious, 16 points.
Yeah, I mean, it's come a lot of different ways from Ivory tonight. He has been fantastic. He's not settling. He's taking the open three when it's there, but he's not settling for the jump shot. That was a hard finish, too.
Wrap. Connor Fry, foul from behind by Matt Smith. A little reach around foul for Smith, his second, team's third of this half.
Yeah.
Or excuse me, team's fourth.
Wolverines will give that to Rapp all night long. He made the 1-3 from deep earlier, but his other shots have been closer to the basket than that. They'll give him that jumper.
Bakersfield's cooled off. They've hit just two of their last eight shots. One of those was the slam dunk. Ivory Young got the hot hand. Jackson's been pretty quiet. Nice dish inside to Deion Goodman. Add one. Ali Ahmed.
Yeah, and the ball movement here beat the zone. They skipped it. They got dribble penetration. And that's Deion. You know, we saw him get called for a couple of travels earlier.
Yeah, that was not much of a foul.
Ahmed gave a reaction like, what in the world? But that was a terrific finish from Deion. And to me, the bright side is the Wolverines are not settling for the long jump shot against the zone. They're trying to drive the gaps. They're trying to get into the paint and then kick it out or take the shots, or a couple times they've hit the roll guy.
Ali Ahmed works it inside. That won't go. Ball goes out of bounds off of UVU, they say. 10 seconds on the shot clock for Bakersfield to work with. That foul on Ahmed, by the way, his third. So now Mays and Ahmed both with three apiece. Aiden Skank just took that one away from everybody. Pushes it up, gives over to Ivory Young.
Bakers with a scrambling on D.
Connor Fry misses from up top. UVU basketball. Bakersfield now just 2 of 10 from the floor. 2 out of their last 10, rather.
Going to get some fresh bodies in here.
Ahmed grimacing as he comes to the bench.
Looks like he got hit in the head. He grabbed his head. He looks tired, too. He's been active inside. And Bakersfield here, Jim, going back to the man-to-man defense, no longer in the zone.
Connor Fry inside. Smith with the rebound for Bakersfield. Both teams have made 6 shots from the floor here in the second half. For Bakersfield, 6 out of 16. For UVU, 6 out of 11.
He traveled, yep.
Arrington.
Moved his left foot.
7th turnover for Bakersfield. It'll bring us to a media timeout. 11:20 to play here at the UCCU Center. Bakersfield leading Utah Valley right now by 5.
See the replay here a few plays ago. That's the thunderous finish from Andrew Bash, and Marcel took the ball away from the screen, drove baseline. Help had to come over. There was a late rotation down the middle for Bakersfield. Andrew Bash had a ton of room in the middle and a great finish.
Six assists from Marcel Davis. Came into this game averaging 4.6 assists per game, fourth best in the WAC.
Really interesting stat for me, Jim, is the Wolverines have 9 turnovers and Bakersfield has turned that into 14 points. No points off turnovers for UVU.
Jackson hanging cover won't go. Ball kicked out of bounds inadvertently off Bakersfield player's foot.
Another trend, Jim, is a lot of these loose balls, a lot of these 50-50 balls that we've seen multiple times here in the second half are all going to UVU, giving them extra shots, extra possessions.
Stank in trouble, gets hammered to the ground. Bakersfield being called for the foul. That one, Justin Hollins.
Yeah, there's clearly a foul, but they're talking about who or whether or not it was a shot or a pass. It was clearly a pass. Wolverine's going to get the ball underneath.
Second foul against Hollins. Sixth team foul. UVU's only been whistled for two. Connor Fry misses the three. So it remains a 5-point lead for Bakersfield, who has not scored in the last over 3.5 minutes now.
Connor Fry now guarding Durham. He's coming off another double screen.
Puts up another three. And Smith with the rebound.
Wow.
And one.
Now that was a forced shot. The Wolverines got exactly what they wanted from Durham because that was a forced off-balance shot from deep. But Smith just working extra hard inside, positioned himself. Long shot equals, this was a short rebound, but you see the shot go up and watch Smith just force his way into the paint. Powerful rebound.
Well, the foul was right there. It was a bigger foul on the rebound than it was on the shot. Skank's second foul, by the way. 7-point lead for Bakersfield. Skank for three. Airballed that one. Bastion pulled it down. Jackson for three. In and out. Bastion with yet another rebound. He stripped on the way up. UVU basketball.
Yeah, what did he just say about those 50-50 balls? They're all going to the Wolverines. Now that's showing their hustle and their effort. Bakersfield at times has been really scrambled, and when you get a long shot like that, you're due for a long rebound.
That three won't go. UVU 6 of 16 shooting. Driving in, missing. The putback is good from Matt Smith.
Yeah, the difference is that Bakersfield is converting on their second chance shots, their offensive rebounds. They're converting. The Wolverines haven't been able to.
20 to 11, the advantage for Bakersfield in second chance points. Ivory Young, floater. Ivory Young with a new career high. 18 points.
Yeah, he's been the life of the Wolverines tonight. And again, another drive, another penetration, pressuring the defense. And Bakersfield doing what they want here. They're trying to slow that game down. They don't want the Wolverines to get into any type of offensive rhythm.
Fry in a little bit of trouble on the backcourt. That's 3-on-3. Under 9 minutes left.
Yeah, Coach Barnes in front of us talking, slow the ball up. He's going to bring his wrap, going to bring the ball out to the half-court line. Question is here, who does Bakersfield go to for offense? And they don't have really any offensive threats in there other than Arrington. He's been the one scorer.
Bastion pulls down his fifth rebound. Jaden Jackson fouled on the way to the hole along the baseline.
Yeah, and the Wolverines are doing a nice job of getting the ball out in transition. You see Ivory pushing the ball. He gets it ahead to Connor. Connor passes it ahead to Jaden. Bakersfield is being really aggressive on the offensive glass. You saw in the previous possession, they double-teamed Connor on the far side. That time, they had two or three guys underneath the basket still trying to rip the ball away for some reason, and Wolverines are capitalizing on Bakersfield's lack of ability to get back in transition.
Six-point lead for Bakersfield. Jackson with 12 points. Buries both his free throws.
Yeah, and Bakersfield now has Ahmed back in the game. They've got Mays back in the game in Durham. So they've got more options offensively here.
And the Wolverines come away with it. And a foul is going to get called, I believe, on Durham. Yep, Damian Durham picks up his second foul. Team's eighth of this half. Bakersfield's been whistled for eight. UVU whistled for three here in this half.
Yeah, nice job of Marcel in the positioning himself. Definitely a foul on Durham. And this is going to be big for UVU. Bakersfield is nowhere near the 1-1. Wolverines eight fouls have drawn on Bakersfield. So for the next 8 minutes, any foul puts UVU at the line, which is going to bode well for them.
Mentioned it earlier that UVU, one of the better free throw shooting teams around, 40th in the nation. Boy, Cardwell and Andrew Basham doing a good job on defense that time. It's Basil and Ahmed. That'll bring us to a media timeout. 7:49 left. Wolverines down by only three here at the UCCU Center. Green Man Group, one of UVU's newest traditions around here. They're probably, what, about 4 years old, this Green Man Group. They've already been invited to Utah Jazz games, a lot of events. Meanwhile, Utah Valley down by just three to Bakersfield. Ivory Young, a career-high 18 points. Jade Jackson in the double figures with 13. Seven each from Marcel Davis and Connor Fry. Meanwhile, for Bakersfield, Durham's got 17 points, 10 from Ali Ahmed. .745 and rolling.
Bakersfield now back to the 3-2 zone.
Cardwell finds Davis for the floater. Wolverines to within one.
And that was a great skip pass. There was so much room on the weak side. Marcel could have taken the three, but a beautiful running running finish.
Seven straight points for UVU. 7 minutes left.
Comes Durham off a two double screen.
Mays backing in against Marcel.
Yeah, Marcel in a tough position there. He was originally guarding Durham, but he got switched off on Mays as was Hayden Skank went out to Durham. It's going to be a charge on Hayden Skank. See that a couple times from him this year, Jim. I mean, you can't fault the aggressiveness, but you see the space that Hayden sees, but watch Mays. I mean, he's standing right there in position for the charge. Got to read where that defender is and either go around, make a dribble move around, or pull up for the jumper.
Third foul against Hayden Skank. Joins Bastion with three fouls each. Ahmed and Mays both with three for Bakersfield. Ahmed, turnaround is good.
That was different. No double team there from UVU. Andrew held his ground, but Ahmed just with a great shot.
12 points for the big man from Egypt. Marcel Davis lost the handle. I believe Bakersfield last to touch it.
Wolverines can be patient against the zone here, like they did the last possession, two possessions ago where they got the skip pass. Coach Barnes is suggesting that the ball, he wants the defense to keep the ball on one side of the floor.
Wolverines just 8 of 20 shooting here in the second half.
Here's Baker still trying to slow it down.
Well, it worked well for Seattle on Thursday night.
Yeah, it did.
Speaking of Seattle, they're leading Grand Canyon on a quick look in by 6 points late in the second half. Ahmed misses. Bakersfield controls.
And the defense here is really compact for the Wolverines. Bakersfield is content with putting two guys in the corner, probably getting some type of screen on the ball. They're going to look to post up Mays inside here one-on-one with Hayden Skank.
Ali Ahmed misses, but a fresh 30 seconds to work with.
And I think they're going to try and go back to Mays here.
Ali Ahmed forces it up.
They're going to get a foul on Hayden Skank, I think. Yep. What a scramble inside, though. A lot of bodies in there.
I think the officials had their choice of a whole bunch of players on this one.
Hayden's going to get called as he goes down. Yeah, see, he's fallen to the ground. Can't keep himself up because he's fallen to the ground, and he fouls Mays.
Fourth foul on Hayden Skank. Mays free throw. This is the first one. Fifth team foul. Fry in, Skank out. 4.5 minutes to play. UVU hasn't led since this game was 3.5 minutes old.
Back to this 3-2 zone here.
Three won't go. Oh,
they're going to get Andrew, I think, over the back, or is it going to be Connor?
Well, it's against UVU. It's going to be Connor Fry.
I mean, that's exactly what you want against the zone. Marcel, perfect penetration, brings the defense to him. Jaden had a great look there. Echoes of Thursday night, just a lot of misses from the corner.
First foul against Connor Fry. Team sixth.
No post up here for Ahmed. He's out of the game.
Smith forces it up and in.
Yeah, they've kind of, Bakersfield's kind of gone to a little bit of a two-man game on the wing. That time Smith came up and set the screen, and then he rolled. Really good finish.
Marcel Davis misses from outside. Bastion with the rebound. And a little reach-in foul stops the clock with 3:49 left. Kevin Mays being called for the foul after one. UVU had drawn to within one at 62-61. It's been seven straight points from Bakersfield. They lead it by eight.
The Western Athletic Conference.
Crunch time here at Utah Valley. 3:49 to play in this game. UVU down by eight to Bakersfield. First time these two have met this season. They'll see each other again 2 weeks from today in Bakersfield. That'll be February 13th. Andrew Bastion will be at the free throw line for Utah Valley. The Wolverines just 12 of 19. 63% free throw shooting. For some teams, that might be good, but for UVU, who averages 74% on the season, not so good. They'll have another. Stops a 7-0 run that Bakersfield was on.
Big free throws there from Andrew. You know, the Wolverines now going to get Alex Carr into the game, almost like an offense-defense type possession. And you see the Wolverines full-court man here. Well, that's exactly what they wanted.
Carr comes up with the steal. Fry for three. Missed it. Smith pulled down that one.
Can't ask for anything more. That was a terrific play.
That would have got this crowd energized.
Yeah, absolutely. That would have been a huge momentum change for UVU. They had a great chance. Bakersfield slowing it down. Let's see if they continue to go to this kind of overloading to some degree one side of the court.
Rapp takes it all the way to the hole and up and in.
Yeah, that was just too easy from Rapp.
He's got 9 points. Coming up with 3 minutes left. Three. Fry. Missed them both. Connor Fry not having a good night from long range. 0 for 6.
Yeah, you're going to get Coach Barnes with his best ball handler lineup here. You see Matt Smith coming out of the game. They'll likely keep Ali Ahmed in the backcourt. You got your best ball handlers for Bakersfield as UVU is going to extend the pressure here. Probably going to try and trap again.
Carr with the guard on wrap. 7 seconds to shoot. Wolverines come up with a turnover. 3-on-1.
Yeah, that's a good foul from Pride. Really good foul.
Ivory Young, yeah, didn't want to get fouled.
Yeah, he was trying desperately to avoid it, but He did not. That's a much better defensive possession, as you see Pride here realizing, hey, I've got a three-on-one coming my way. I'm gonna draw the foul or get the foul called because it would have been a sure 2 points.
So to put Ivory up at the free throw line. Double bonus for Utah Valley already, so every foul will be a two-shot foul for UVU. UVU just not shooting well from the stripe. 14 of 22 now. Not shooting well from the three either.
Yeah, get the make here. Cut it to seven, then try and get a steal. As they're going to be pressing. Coach Barnes anticipating. Yeah, Ivory missed both of them. Wolverine's going to have to extend pressure here.
Eight-point lead for Bakersfield. Mays make it 10. Their biggest lead of the game. Skank.
It's going to be a block. Yeah, that's a good call.
Clock stop, 2:01. UVU has hit only, goodness, two of their last 15 shots. Meanwhile, Bakersfield, three of their last three. Two teams going in opposite directions here.
Yeah, here Hayden pushing the action as he has to. A few plays ago, that was the charge that it was Matt Smith drew, I believe. Yeah, those two free throws, unfortunately, Ivory's misses were critical for the Wolverines because Bakersfield was able to come down and get 2 points of their own.
Gets the first free throw down.
I'll be interested to see what UVU does here because they've got time, 2 minutes left. Make or miss, they're probably going to extend pressure and try and get a foul call. We get a timeout here from Coach Pope.
Just a 30-second timeout, although this one might get stretched into a 60.
Yeah, they're gonna stretch it into a 60.
Skank now with 5 points. So technically, this being the first coach's timeout of the second half, it does get turned into a long 60-second timeout. 73-65, Wolverines trying to pull this thing out to remain in the battle at the top of the WAC standings. They came in here tied with Seattle for fourth place in the WAC standings. Took another quick look in on the Seattle game. With 12 seconds to play, Seattle and Grand Canyon tied at 57.
How about Seattle? You know, what a tough win they came in here and earned on Thursday, and then going to Grand Canyon. Wow, Seattle won it.
Seattle wins 59-57. Grand Canyon loses their first game in the Western Athletic Conference. They're now 6-1. New Mexico State is all over Rio Grande Valley. So now New Mexico State and Grand Canyon are tied, will be tied as soon as New Mexico State wraps this thing up with Rio Grande. New Mexico State out in front by 24 points with less than a minute to play. So Grand Canyon, New Mexico State, both 6-1 in conference play. Bakersfield at 4-2 right now. Tied with Seattle, Seattle half a game back and forth. I'm confusing myself now. Suffice it to say, UVU really needs to win this game.
Yeah, they do. You know, in the last 2 minutes here, they're going to get a lineup that can handle the ball from Bakersfield. You do your best, get a steal on the inbounds, and then try and steal. You don't necessarily, I don't think you necessarily want a foul right now because Bakersfield would be at the free throw line. But try and get a steal, try and get a trap somewhere without fouling. And if you don't get that ball, you obviously fall back into your defense.
Under two to play.
Wow, nice play from Hayden.
Very heads-up play by the walk-on.
Now Bakersfield's got to be ripping their hair out because they had it. They just Arrington put too much air under the ball. Ahmed unable to come down with it, and Hayden right in the perfect spot. You couldn't ask for anything better because you got the turnover and you got possession. Not much time ran off the clock, 8 seconds. You know, run your offense, get the best shot you can right here. Bakersfield in 3-2 again.
There's a three from Ivy. That was the first field goal since the 7:22 mark of this game for UVU. They've hit some free throws since then.
Now you can't ask for anything better. It was play designed to get a baseline drive and a skip pass. Jaden, you know, kind of, I think, initially drawn up for Jaden if he didn't have it. It was just one extra kick right there to Ivory, and the man of the night knocks down another one.
Ivory Young, career high 21 points on 8 of 12 shooting. He's hit 4 out of 6 from long range.
And Matt Smith, injured there on the bench, he was the one that challenged Jaden initially in the corner. He went up high, got airborne, must have come down on his ankle wrong, tweaked it a little bit. Wolverines going back to their kind of defensive lineup with Alex in the game.
Minute and a half. Wolverines almost coming up with a steal. They're going to give it to Utah Valley. Pressure cooker time now.
Absolutely. You know, you never try and pass over the defense there. Ivory anticipating it, getting in the passing lane. Clearly off of Bakersfield. Great defense there from Ivory and Marcel.
Jaden Daxson for three. My goodness, how many have gone in and out tonight? Ivory commits the foul at midcourt. Clock stopped 1:12 to play. Utah Valley has put up 22 three-pointers and made six. It's 27% if you're counting at home. They shot a measly 31% on Thursday night here against Seattle. The bad news is second half shooting from long range for UVU, 1 out of 12.
And these are big free throws from Durham, who makes the first one, but big free throws from him because it's still plenty of time left.
Just a 1-1. It was only the seventh team foul.
That ball was in and out too, Jim, for Jaden. It was right there.
Six-point Bakersfield lead. One minute left. Connor Fry forces it up. That won't go. Jaden Daxson forced a foul with 53.7. Well, it's just going to be ice cold shooting that doomed the Wolverines if they can't pull this one out.
You know, what was the last key that we talked about at the first of the game? It was make open shots.
Yeah.
And they've got terrific looks. They just have not been able to knock down those shots.
UVU's only made 9 shots in the second half from the floor.
9 shots, is that what you said, Jim?
Yep.
How many of those have been threes?
One.
1-3.
1 out of 12 from long range, 9 out of 27 overall in the second half. In fact, UVU has scored 10 points from the free throw line. They've made more free throws than they have shots from the floor. 8-point lead. Basketball, 39.2 left. Skink kicks out to Young. He's got the hot hand. My goodness. Ivory Young should have the ball in his hand every possession. Ivory Young, 24 points. Folks, coming in here before tonight, his career high was 17 against, that was against Rio Grande.
And just spacing it out, you know, Bakersfield thinking, you know what, we'll just try and stop the drives, but that's the one guy you don't want to leave open is Ivory Young, and he is in a rhythm. What is he? He is 5 of 7 from 3. The rest of the team, that would put them at 2 of 18, right? My math is right there.
2 of, yeah, something. the rest of the team's hit 2.
Now, and the Wolverines keep fighting, Jim. Not over yet. Once again, you get the ball inbound just as you want it. Bakersfield has had a little bit of trouble with bringing the ball up, and maybe the Wolverines can catch another break with a turnover.
8 fouls against UVU, 11 against Bakersfield, so UVU in the double bonus. It'll be Bakersfield probably going to the free throw line, though.
UVU no more timeouts, Jim. So, you know, regardless of what happens, keep that in mind, no more timeouts. Bakersfield does have 3 left. Second call.
Rapp did not get the timeout. He's saying, yes, I was signaling for it. Where was the whistle? Not going to get that call here. So still 32.7.
I tried to skip pass right to Ivory. There it was.
Jay Jackson for 3 short. Skink misses the easy follow. Connor Fry tried to go back up with it. Clock stopped 16.8.
Hayden just with barely with the miss there. Fighting inside. Off wrap.
UVU basketball. 14 and a half seconds left.
Let's go Wolverines.
Ivory Young, turnaround. He's unconscious. Clock stopped 11.3. 27 points for Ivory Young.
These are pressure free throws right here.
Connor Fry committing the foul. Wow. How'd they call that foul on Connor Fry? Now they change it to say Ivory Young. Thank you. Second foul against Ivory.
This is a 1-1 here too, Jim.
Three-point lead for Bakersfield. UVU down by 4 with 11.3 seconds left. Harrington now, 12 points.
Harrington, the best free throw shooter for Bakersfield, 77% on the year. He's come through tonight, 2-7 of 8. Those were incredibly tough free throws.
Well, this is a Bakersfield team that's dead last in the Western Athletic Conference in free throw shooting at just 64% for the season. They've got 15 out of 20. That's good for 75% tonight. It's UVU came in here smoking everything at 74%, 40th best in the nation. And they go 16 of 25 from the free throw line thus far,
yeah,
64%.
Bakersfield only has two guys in the 70s for free throw percentage. It's Arrington and it's Basil. Basil, I don't think, has attempted any free throws tonight. He hasn't, but Arrington's been big. 11.3 seconds here, Jim. I think most of the philosophies are you get the best shot that you can. You know, if you're the offense, you try and push that ball, you know, get to the rim if you can. Maybe look for the kick out if it's there. But the defense is going to be on its heels because they know if they foul, you're at the free throw line, points potential with the clock stoppage. So I'm interested to see what Bakersfield does as far as their defense. It looks like they are going to go with the 3-2 zone again. They're extending it here, but they're going to fall back. Best shot possible here.
Ivory Young forces it up. Bakersfield comes away with it. And that's how this one will end. 78-74. Wolverines lose this one by 4 points. Wolverines overall now 9-13 on the season. They fall to 5-6 at home. More importantly, they fall to 3-4 in the Western Athletic Conference. Meanwhile, Bakersfield improves to 15-7, 6-6 on the road, and they are now 5-2 in the WAC and nipping at the heels of Grand Canyon and New Mexico State. We'll take a break. We'll come back and talk about this one in our postgame show here on UVU TV. My goodness, what a game here at the UCCU Center. Utah Valley loses this one by four. Final score 78-74 in favor of Bakersfield. Matt, not much to say other than UVU was ice cold.
They were ice cold and missed shots at really critical points in the game. You know, they fought with their defense. They were right there, and they just couldn't get that one basket to fall as they needed. See the stats here. We mentioned it at halftime. It was a really evenly played game. It played out that way for the full 40 minutes. You know, turnovers the same, rebound. Just look through the list there. All really close, except for the second item down there for the Wolverines. 8 of 26.
That's
from
terrible.
3. 8 of 26 from 3. Bakersfield, that's not their style of play. They were 7 of 12, which for them is really good shooting. It it was one of the keys of the game. We talked about controlling the pace. Wolverines maybe didn't get to the pace that they wanted to. Their rebounding was pretty good. I didn't think they were hurt with rebounding. But one of the keys that we said was they had to make open shots, and they didn't make the open shots tonight, and that's why they came away with the loss.
All right, UVU now is going to be in, fifth place in the Western Athletic Conference standings. Grand Canyon, New Mexico State tied at the top at 6-1 record. Bakersfield going to be alone in third at 4-2. Seattle at 4-3, Bakersfield at 5-2. And Seattle at 4-3, and then Utah Valley at 3-4. Now they got to turn around and play everybody in the WAC one more time before we all head down to Las Vegas. So Wolverines have their work cut out for them now.
They do. I mean, you take these games and you learn from them. I think the Wolverines unfortunately took a step back in these two home games after the two road victories that they came up with. But, you know, you build on it. You look at what the positives were throughout the game. And, I mean, you get a shot to fall here or there, a timely three, not a turnover or one of the second chance opportunities that they got to fall. And it's a different ball game because their defense, I thought, was pretty good. They held the Roadrunners in check for most of the game. Durham did have a little bit of a breakout game with his 18 points, but, I mean, they kept competing throughout the whole game. It just didn't turn for them when they needed it.
Ivory Young, wow, 27 yeah. points tonight, career high for him. And meanwhile, Connor Fry, the team's leading scorer coming in here at 15 a game, ends up with 7. So yeah. Those two flip-flop positions tonight.
Rough shooting night, overall, that was what we're talking about. Ivory was the standout player of the game. Jaden had 13 points. He played well,
steady.
But I don't know if – I'm not sure if he scored in the second half. We'll have to check the halftime stats there, but
He did not.
Yeah, I think he did. It looks like he did score 5 points.
Wrong sheet. I only have 48 sheets of paper in front of me. We've killed a tree tonight.
5 points in the second half, but those were the only two Wolverines in double figures, and the balanced scoring wasn't there. They had a lot of guys that scored, but obviously not enough. So tough one to swallow, these last two for UVU. You've got a lot to think about, a lot to work on, and hopefully they'll be able to recover and keep competing and keep fighting. They got a lot ahead of them.
Wolverines hit the road two next week, at Rio Grande on Thursday and then at New Mexico State a week from tonight. Very tough place to play. Hey, that's going to do it for us. Thanks for being with us tonight from the UCCU Center. This telecast produced by students from the UVU Digital Media Department. It's been a copyrighted production of Utah Valley University and the Wolverine Sports Network. For Matt Peterson, I'm Jim McCullough. Thanks so long for more on Utah.